Why do twins fascinate us? Why do we stare?
Why do we scrutinize and compare every feature for small differences?
Can the sameness of twins tell us something deeper about what makes us each different and alike?
This place,
Twinsburg, Ohio,
it has the best twin watching in the world.
Each year, thousands of multiples come.
They come to be around their kind, to celebrate what they share.
They even come to help science unravel the mysteries of our genes and personalities.
The press comes to gawk. What a spectacle for the cameras.
That's not us. I'm Jeff.
And I'm Tom.
We're twin reporters who came to learn about why science thinks we're special.
So we were questioned.
We were sampled.
We were screened.
We were recorded.
And we learned how unique the annual Twin Days Festival is to researchers.
We're here in Twinsburg looking at how genes influence news behavior.
We're here to measure the sense of taste and smell in human twins.
Twins give us an interesting data set specifically because they're identical. And so if you try to develop a better face recognition system, if you can differentiate between identical twins, it's a lot easier to differentiate between non-twin individuals.
So we hope that your genetics will relate to your patterns of not only news use, but social media use generally.
In this particular project, we're looking at the sense of being able to sense fat. And we don't know if people are able to taste fat in a traditional way or whether it's more textural. So one quick way into that is to determine whether it's more of a genetic thing or more of a behavioral or a non-genetic thing.
You have a fingerprint reader on your iPhone. You gain access to bank accounts through voice recognition. You can gain access to your phone through selfies. As more and more of the population becomes involved with biometrics, I think we need to be able to differentiate between similar individuals more because it makes the systems more robust.
How many people did you put through the test, including us,
this week? So today we did 150 today and 300 yesterday, so 450 in total, including you guys. I mean, we can do in 4 hours what it takes us a year to do in the lab recruiting individual twins. So it's really very efficient, and it's really great having the subjects who really care sort of about the underlying biology.
You know, there's really no place else in the country where you can get this number of twins together at one point in time. We know because we've looked.
Here's how important is it from a study standpoint to have subjects this closely matched?
The non-scientific, non-tactful answer is we'd be screwed because having that piece of information, at least from a behavior genetic standpoint, that you have identical twins, that is invaluable information that you cannot replicate in any other way. True, you know, identical twins especially are incredibly important for all sorts of scientific fields, not just social science, but in the hard science as well.
In our 37 years together,
we've never been around more than one or two other sets of twins.
Here, we met thousands in 3 days.
And finally understood how amazing twins are
to science
and to each other.